Like much. Oh, hey guys. Oh yeah. Spread that fear and I don't know, leprosy or whatever the hell bloody pox does. And we have another gate. I wonder if that also probably leads to the aforementioned bullshit. Jesus Christ, and another one! There's no BS behind the gate. I am sure. And secrets for days. This is like the third one in this area alone. Makes me wonder just how many I've missed in the rest of the game. Oh, and there's a freaking shrine up here, nice. Oh. Like, I'm looking at my minimap and I'm like, yeah, there's a shrine as I like slowly move along. Then I look at the like rest of the game and I'm like, oh, there's a bunch of bones and shit. Oh, hey, look, it's the bone hunter. I'm just gonna go ahead and let my minions do what my minions do. Blight Fiend tanking like a pro. Blight Fiend now a corpse. Oh, no, it's okay. Wow. Alright. We pet the doggo and it was found wanting. Fang of the Bone Hunter quest item. Huh, alright. I don't know where to store it. Like, our inventory is pretty well capped up here. Inventory is full. Templar's leg armor. I assume that's pants. Fancy pants! Health, defensive ability, fire and lightning resist. Fire resist is nice. A little bit of lightning retaliation on there. Not bad, not bad. Alright.
I can't think.
Yeah, I don't think I have room for any of this. Jesus Christ. And I'm like, hey, guess what, buddy? Have some more. You wanted more. Fang is an optional quest item. The character might have incurred the quest giver and depending on the choice, killed her. Oh, shit. Alright. I don't believe I have been here on my other character, like, this far back. Like, I probably just, like, came down here and got bored or something, because on my other character, I have not been nearly as thorough. I don't know. Or maybe I've got that thing sitting in my inventory, taking up space. Huh. Keep an eye out for whoever that's for. Pierce bleed, health, energy regen, armor, athlete, bleeding retaliation, kind of a wasted effect there. It will take your space until you travel way further. Okay, gotcha. So many components. Mighty frontier pants of blight. These pants have seen a lot. Vitality and poison damage, though. That's kind of a big deal. Versus plus 8% to all damage and a fair amount of health. But it does have plus 5 physique. Let's see how it compares. Oof. Losing 250 health. Do I have in my... Or I do not. A full one of these. Let's see. I accidentally just sold that. I think you do that. This is a maybe. What else do we have? Lightning and Aether is a no. That is two-handed. Pet bonus. Pet bonus. We wanna... Oh, hey, we got another troll mate. Very nice. More vitality damage, and poison damage, and cunning. Again, though, at the cost of health. And elemental resistances, which... Yeah, so that's the thing, though, is, like, more poison bolt. Which, really, I don't know how useful that would be for us specifically, because, like, I mean, the only real attacks I do, like, when a fight starts, I'll cast Reap Spirit once, and, like, Ravenous Earth once, and then by the time that's over, like, the fight's dead. Like, everything's dead. Even boss fights, I might only get, like, another Ravenous Earth. I mean, I'll throw, like, Bloody Pox, I guess. I think it's probably worth losing a little bit of health. Like, we can afford to lose some health, and I will be gaining it back when I resocket components on these things. To bring up the damage of my Bloody Pox and Ravenous Earth. Because that's 108 and 111 versus 98 and 102. Okay, so it's not that big of a buff, actually. That's 64. To 70. Yeah, based on that, like, that's not that substantial. So yeah, I think I'm just gonna sell those.
Put to good use.
Oh, we've got to dump so much garbage. So much.
Got something you need stashed?
Jesus Christ. Got something you need stashed? Yeah, like three quarters of my inventory. Want to buy component pouch. That's one thing that I've actually put a lot of thought into for post-fiancé game, because I want to actually have a crafting system in that as well. And I've decided that, like, with regards to crafting components and stuff, that it's gonna be, like, stored in a secondary inventory, so you don't have to worry about it, just for ease of play. Sanctified bone. Anything else? Okay, I wanna do... Oh, wait, I was gonna say, like, I wanna put the bristly furs back in my things, but I don't need to. What can I put on my belt? I just realized we have this belt, and I have put nothing in it. We have scavenge plate, which is garbage. You have one shared stash tab for all components, and it takes it up completely. Jesus Christ. Oh, that is crazy. I didn't think that there were that many components in this. Like, even on my higher level guy, like, I've about got filled what I have here. Like, I maybe have an extra row down below, and that's about it. Okay, so I want to take, I guess, all of this. This is all going into my shared stack. I'm just going to throw all this over here, where I won't have to worry about it. I'm going to throw these in here, so that I remember to transfer them to my mules. That there. That can go there. What in the hell is this? Vendor trash that I've apparently been holding on to for some reason. Malmoth added, like, something like, that makes sense, I suppose. Do they, like, are there, on, like, higher difficulties, are there different components that you can only find on, like, Ultimate and stuff? I've not noticed any in my play on Elite, but again, I'm still fairly early into it. Other high-level components and a butt ton you can only craft. Gotcha. Alright, that makes sense. Yeah, like, admittedly, I've not gotten super deep into crafting, like, the extra components and stuff, because it's just... It is such a huge list, and it is a pain in the ass to navigate through it. Like, it's just cumbersome. But that's probably something I should just, like, look on the wiki for. Something Something like 100 of them. Wow. All right. I mean, I guess that's fair. Like that. I can see that, I suppose. Oh, Jesus Christ. Goes and stashes a bunch of shit, forgets to stash shit. All right. So I'm gonna hold on to this. Didn't I stuff the other one in the stash? Of course I did. Forgets to stash all of the shit. Highest level components are level 75. Jesus Christ. Yeah, my main is like, I think 68 maybe? He's in the high 60s, somewhere thereabouts. And progressing nicely as far as I'm concerned through elite. Okay, that's all that. These things can just, like, I think I'm gonna skip through these, like the Imperial Proclamations and stuff. There. But I'm actually gonna read the ones that sound like they're interesting, like Creed's notes and like writings and stuff. So I guess we can hammer through these real quick here. The Hidden Path, Solail. We found this runestone. You've traveled far, seeker, and seen much, but still the veil between worlds blinds you to the deeper truths. You stumble about this world we inhabit, eager for answers about the Empire and its Luminari deny. They think us heretics, followers of false gods, and yet none of them can claim to have witnessed the power of their deities. Their illusions. Show me the cripples that Menhir has cured, the armies that Alaron has toppled, the beasts that Mogrigan spared from the hunt. You cannot, because they are not real, but the witch gods, born of man and ascended to raise us from our ignorance, if you are willing to listen, they may open your eyes as well. You now stand before the shrine of Solail, the youngest of the three. Eldritch Fire is at his behest, the very essence of the Eldritch Realm, his mold and shape as he sees fit. Clothed in black robes that hide his gaunt form, Solail glides unseen through the shadowy veil to hunt unwilling mortals for their vitality. Many a devout of Solail has been asked to make the ultimate sacrifice, to present themselves before the Dark God and offer their life so that he may bestow his infinite wisdom upon those that remain. You, worthy seeker, do not yet have the attention of the gods, but know that with each step you take, you bring yourself closer to the three. Go now to the frozen lands of the north, where primitive tribes had constructed standing stones ages ago. Armed with the words of Solail and Drieg, the way shall be open to you. Okay. Osman's folly. They all say I'm insane for taking this caravan through the deep road. The only thing that's insane is paying bribes to those smug bastards in control of Smuggler's Pass. May as well pay the Imperial tariffs. Heard on a good account that the dangers in the mountain deeps are well overblown, and the exit will spit us out far closer to Homestead than the bandit-ridden pass. I'm swinging gold up to my neck down in Berwich. Then they'll all see that Bozeman was right. Living armor. Level 75 gives 35% offensive ability, 8% chaos, 10% elemental resistances, and 10% or something increased armor rating. Holy shit. They scoff at what you're currently using. They're madly expensive. Oh, of course. Oh, 35 offensive ability, not percent. Gotcha. No, like, I know even, like, I've got some recipes for some of them. Like, for example, I'm using, like, the chilled steel in here. I think I have, like, the upgrade for that. I love it. I go to the stash to do crafting, because that makes sense. Like, yeah, I know that you can, like, really, like, if you want to go hard into these things, like, you can. Like, Hell's Bane ammo, Flintcore bolts, stuff like that. Enchanted Flint, the upgrade for Searing Embers. Like, yeah, I know that there's, like, you work yourself down the crafting tree type thing. It's just that, fuck. That's a lot of work. Speaking of which, I probably should replace these chilled steel components with something that's not chilled steel. Something that's maybe poisonous. If we have anything like that. Like maybe some mutagenic ichor. Acid and poison damage. Of course it converts physical to acid instead of physical to poison. Because physical to poison would be useful. Oh hey, mutated scales, there you go. There's some better like better stuff to slot into my armor, an upgrade from the bristly fur, a substantial upgrade from bristly fur. There are components that get pet buffs, of course there are. Impaling weapons. Really? Huh. Well, there's one. Just want to kind of see what we've got floating around here. Physical to acid is correct. Oh, okay. It does change internal trauma to poison damage. Gotcha. All right. Good to know. Ooh. There are just so many things. So many things. Drieg's infinite gaze. Interesting. I'll never use it, but interesting. Alright, I want to come down here really quick and see if I can craft anything worth throwing in my pets here. Like, I wish there were a way to, like, quickly, like, to scroll through this list with, like, the information on the right one at a time instead of having to use the mouse wheel, like, to chunk it down, because I lose my place. There we go, some resistance for our pets. And chaos resistance for ourselves. Aether resistance. Okay, we're going to be using this, right? Yes. Get even more move speed on our boat, or on our boots. That's actually ridiculous, but tempting. Also, I can't craft it. It takes ward stones, which... Yeah, that's too much work. Far too much work. Alright, so we have an upgrade here. Petrolic does give poison and acid damage. True. Sure, why not? 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. Oh, and it grants us envenomed weapons, which actually gives our pets bonuses too. Wonderful. Okay, cool. More toggles. I'm all about toggles, except I'm like running out of space to put things now. Crate, give me more buttons, please. Give me like a third. Give me a third wheel. Give me a third row of things to put things on. Please, I'm begging you. Okay, there we go. Now, come in here to paling weapons. I guess on mouse 5 we will throw in venom weapons. There we go. Hey look, I'm actually reserving an amount of mana I can see now. And my pets also do poison damage. Awesome. Get away from me guys, look at my beautiful pixels. You can barely even see my character past all these status effects flying around on me. Wonderful. Okay. Back to reading. The one they call Uruburuk makes mockery of the gods. The Lord Executioner cutted his flesh, but the wounds refused to bleed. His limbs grew back. His skin is impervious to flame. Yes, you can see the finger. All that matters is that we can see the finger. I believe the time has come for me to descend into the vile place and deal with the heathen myself. We shall see how he reacts to the cleansing flame of the divine. Alright, Inquisitor Creed. God, dude, you are so fucking wordy. How much time has passed since my last entry? Following my escape from Craig's laboratory, I have raced against time and lost. Passed through darkness and flame, and witnessed the ruin of the world as I knew it. Even as I assumed key figures of the capital were likely to be possessed by the entities we now call Aetherials, I reasoned it was only with the support from within the capital that we could hope to thwart them. Any action that began outside the capital would be spun as political rebellion and crushed with the Empire's own forces before the truth could be exposed. Thus, I cast the dice and raced towards the heart of Irulan, trying to conceal myself as best I could. Upon my arrival, I proceeded cautiously, booking a room at a squalid inn near the west gates in an effort to keep my arrival secret. Initially, I sought out old acquaintances, assuming if I could detect change in personality or behavior, it might reveal possession. A few awkward reunions made it painfully obvious that years on the road carrying out my duties as an inquisitor had left me out of touch and unable to discern whether any changes were the result of possession or just the passage of time and faded memories. The only gamble left then was to report back to the Citadel of the Luminari and see what came of it. I never made it there. Waiting until the sunlight dwindled and crowds thinned in the streets below, I rose to leave, but was quite startled to see a sad, shadowy figure had somehow silently breached my room, evading all the wards I had set for intruders. This is the first time I came into cooperation with the First Blade. Good old Ulgrim! It was known that anyone of significance who'd fomented discontent or posed a real threat to the rule of the Emperor might be visited by the First Blade. I'd never stirred such controversy, but I always imagined if such an encounter took place, I could put up a respectable fight. I never got the chance. Taken unawares, I was disarmed before I even knew what was happening. Had he sought my death, I would have not even witnessed the killing stroke fall. However, he seemed more interested in answers instead, and in turn provided me with an account of his own events that conformed my worst fears. The First Blade revealed that only days prior, he had been forced to turn his knives on the Emperor himself by his own command. Despite the myriad safeguards protecting the Emperor, both mundane and arcane, he had become host to an Aetherial. Through strength of mind, he had usurped his possessor long enough to summon the First Blade, command his own execution, and charge the assassin with ensuring his son, the young prince, survived to reclaim the throne. His last commands issued, the Emperor's consciousness slipped once again under the control of the Aetherial, and a desperate battle ensued. First Blade reported that he believed that the Emperor and the Aetherial within him slain, but, given his inexperience with the entities, could not say anything for certain. He relayed that he had secretly taken the prince and put him into hiding, but declined to elaborate. The First Blade said he intended to retire his imperial title and had chosen the name Ulgrim, which made me curious as to whether it was an intentional reference to the mythic character. A final troubling detail was that no proclamation of the Emperor's passing has been issued. Not only did this demonstrate the Aetherials had sufficient control of the palace to conceal the death, but, given that they couldn't hope to hide the Emperor's absence for long, it is suggested that the next phase of their operation was imminent. I strategized with Ulgrim long into the night, formulating a plan to counter the Aetherials, but ultimately we agreed that we could not defeat the conspiracy in time. The only course left was to gather whatever people and resources we could, go to ground, and weather the coming storm, then find a way to counter the invaders. We agreed that the Black Legion would be our best hope in securing allies. With a conscripted army of criminals, debtors, and political dissidents bound to service, it seemed unlikely that the Aetherials would have any reason to infiltrate them when they could control them indirectly through the military high command. The next step was to discreetly make contact. Freaking people being all political intrigue-y. It is a good indicator of just how screwed over the world is, though. Like, that is one thing that I like in this, is that, like, God, how to explain it. Like, the things that destroyed the world, I mean, they're obviously, like, running around sowing physical chaos in the world. But that most of, like, the damage just came from the fact that they kind of, like, usurped government control and stuff before they decided to bring in all the Cthulhu monsters. That's pretty great. Come on, guys, knock down the gate. Ooh, what do we got? We got steps. Oh, yeah, I was gonna say, a bunch of freaking gravestones. Hey, level 40. Sneaky level 40, I didn't even see that coming. I don't know what is going on here, but there are things. Everybody dead? I think everything's dead. No? Where did this stuff even come from? It's like spawning in behind me. Alright. Rubberaxe Journal, page 1. Oh boy. Something powerful is coming from beyond. I have sensed its approach for some time now, but like a dream or some distant memory. The details were lost to me until now. I can feel it clawing its way through the veil somewhere to the northeast of Burwich. No doubt drawn here by the maelstrom of otherworldly corruption. I dare say its nature eludes even me, but it is neither flesh nor spirit. Let's discover what it is we are facing, and should the need arise, seal it away again behind the barrier between worlds. The Order need not concern itself with these matters quite yet. I must do this alone. Urubruk. That is a brave thing to do when you're fighting Cthulhu monsters, my friend. And with that, I think we might be done in this area. There's a little bit we haven't explored up here that I want to check. That's it. This was a good side area. Holy crap. Alright. Has got anything hidden up here? Just a stump. By the look of it. Done for now, and I missed the thing. Holy shit, seriously? Wow. I thought I was pretty thorough with this. Alright. I mean, like, if we're coming back, I'm not too worried, I suppose. That'll be a thing for another time.
Okay, let us go to...
I guess back to Homestead. Now we gotta kill bugs. Terrible, terrible bugs. Request we already started. Oh, really? Hidden path related, huh? It's either that or a merciful end, which is in the Broken Hills, which is not that area, I don't believe. Yeah, Broken Hills is down here. The Lutra the Abandoned. We'll find and deal with him eventually. Alright, so... Well, I mean, shit, I guess... I was pretty thorough with this, too. All we missed is a little side here and that. I am not going to backtrack all the way back down there just to clear those two little chunks of map. So... Oh, that's right, we gained a level, too. Aha! Oh, it's the fourth step. Okay, that's fair. Yeah, in that case, I'm not worried. Because that's like post-Act 4, well, Act 4-ish stuff. So I'm not too worried. Bloody pox with fevered rage. 150% increased total speed. Holy shit. It's good when you hate your melee teammates. Well, my thinking is that I hit them with bloody pox, right? And then I fear them so that they run away. Which, like, that would be, I think, really good for, like, trash monsters. But, like, I know me well enough to know that I'll, like, accidentally throw bloody pox with fevered rage on a boss monster, and it will then proceed to insta-gib my entire group. So I think that's probably something that I'm going to stay away from. I'm gonna grab Decay. Just to get some extra damage for our roiling soil. And then I think that's probably going to be about it. Then I'm going to be investing into, like, my offensive skills. And now we're going to start buffing our minion levels a little bit. Thornsberry Farm. Just try it. Dangerous game. Check every house, there's a hidden thing here. All right, I will keep an eye out. I'm only gonna be going for like another half hour, so I don't think we're gonna get too far out here, but next time we will definitely tear into it pretty good. Want to see what we got up here. Oh, this is just the farmers. Yeah.